Hi, I'm Marc Stevens, author of Government Indicted. My website, of course, is markstevens.net, where we're working to bring about a voluntary society, one visitor at a time, and one show at a time. The No State Project is live every Saturday from 4 to 7 Eastern Standard Time on the Liberty Radio Network. That is LRN.FM. And like anything else on this website or on the radio show, if you disagree with something that I have presented, you are more than welcome to join me during a live broadcast and present your evidence and show where the issues presented, the facts were wrong. And I just want to do, this is a call to shame I mentioned on this broadcast here for May 28, 2016. It's a call to shame from, so it's going to go right here under the call of shames. And this is what prompted us to call. Greg and I had called this Royce Larson. And that's going to be the subject of the call of shame, which is immediately after this short video. It'll just run into it. We had asked Royce there at the Franchise Tax Board to provide evidence to support the argument that just because Greg was physically in California, the Constitution laws applied. So what he did was he sent a standard form letter. You can see that this is a standard form letter. Okay, so I'm not saying that Roger Larson or Royce Larson wrote this. He didn't, but he thought it was appropriate. And I just want to show, and so this is instrumental and, you know, really help to understand really just how off base Roy is during the phone call. So I want to point out, when you're asking for evidence to prove your Constitution, which is just a written instrument, written by men and women, ordinary men and women, without magical powers, if you're asked for evidence to prove that that applies to someone just because they're physically in California, just citing it isn't proof. But what's interesting here is, even though it's completely non-responsive, he is saying that the basis of their authority and their laws is the Constitution. Now, this is important if you're interested in logic. So it's supposed to be that the Constitution is the law of the land, and the laws have to be constitutional, that the authority for the laws is the Constitution. And it's saying right here, the California Constitution grants the California legislative authority. California Constitution, Article 4, Section 1. This includes the power to tax, blah, blah. Yeah, if it applies. So what Royce tries to do is turn this logic on its head, trying to provide some kind of evidence to prove that the Constitution, a written instrument, applies to Greg just because he's physically in California. It doesn't work. There is no evidence. It couldn't be. He then had to go down and state that we will not respond to further objections you make about state taxes based on constitutional, religious, or moral grounds. If you have difficulty understanding California's income tax law, and they also talk about search for frivolous to review the truth about frivolous tax arguments. We ask for evidence. It's not an argument. And also, even if it was construed as an argument, it is not an argument of law. It is not a legal argument. It's not a legal question. It's a question of fact or an issue of fact. So it's completely non-responsive, but that's what they do. That's what they do. You disagree with us, frivolous. It's the only damn word these predators seem to know. But you'll see that Royce Larson does a pitiful job of trying to provide to support his argument and the claim that the Constitution applies to Greg in any way, just because he's physically in California. Again, my name is Marc Stevens, the No State Project, live every Saturday from 4 to 7 Eastern Standard Time on LRN.FM. The website, of course, markstevens.net.
And your name, sir?
My name is Marc.
And Greg, you're able to hear me right now?
Yes, I can hear you.
All right, good morning. Thank you. And this call may be recorded or monitored for quality assurance purposes. And you give me permission to speak with Marc regarding your personal income tax matters?
Yes.
All right, thank you. You can go ahead, Marc.
Yeah, we have, he had gotten, of course, as you can see, a demand for a tax return.
Correct.
And he had sent a letter and asking for evidence to support your arguments or claims that the Constitution applied to him just because he's physically in California. He got a standard form letter back from Royce Larson.
Yes, that would be myself.
Oh, that's you?
That's correct.
Oh. I'm sorry, I wrote down. Okay. Well, it's not actually...
Is this regarding 2014?
All tax years.
All tax years.
But it's probably in response to the 2014.
Okay, that's what I'm seeing here as well.
Okay. See, the question was a matter of evidence. Do you have any actual proof that just because he's physically in California that your constitution applies to him?
Well, based on the revenue and taxation code, the California residents would be taxed on all sources of income, minus any exclusion.
Yeah, my question is, do you have any actual facts that would prove that just because he's physically in California, your constitution applies to him?
Well, based on the information that we do have, he would have a filing requirement, so that would... Based on the constitutionality letter that we sent out, that does inform him of our authority to pursue the tax year, and based on the reported wages and California resident, he would have a filing requirement.
Okay, let's take.
And if he chooses not to file, then this also informs him that a filing enforcement would be created in place of an actual return, which is estimated based on standard deduction and a single as a filing status.
Yes, but my question is, and maybe you get a little specific, what specific facts prove that just because he's physically in California that your constitution applies to him?
Okay. Again, that information would be located on our revenue and taxation code. Now, each specific section regarding that, that's something that if you want to look up or become familiar with, that would be your discretion. But that's what we're currently following is revenue and taxation code, and that's tax law.
I get that, but you're referencing in your form letter here the Constitution, so. I'm asking you for specific facts that would prove that your constitution applies to Greg just because he's physically in California.
What kind of proof are you referring to?
I'm asking, you're the one who is making the claim that the constitution applies to him because he's physically in California. What proof do you have to support that claim?
And what kind of proof are you looking for?
Do you have evidence? Do you have specific facts proving that just because he is physically in California, your constitution applies to him?
Well, it would apply to him being a California resident, but do I have, facts offhand? No, I do not. Is that something that you would request or would like? That's something, if you want to submit that in writing, we can definitely respond to that.
He's already responded in writing, and you responded with a form letter. So you're telling me on the phone right now, I heard you very clear. I just want to make sure. At this time on the phone, you can't provide any specific facts that would prove your constitution applies to him just because he's physically in California.
Again, I would just need to refer you to the Revenue and Taxation Code to look up the information, but do I have that specific information offhand? No, I do not.
Okay. You're kind of confusing thing. I'm asking you for specific facts that prove your constitution applies to him because he's physically in California. You keep seeming to want to go back. You initially said you don't have the proof, but then you said something about the Revenue and Taxation Code. Are you actually trying to convince us? Wait, let me finish. Are you actually trying to convince me that the facts proving your constitution apply to him is something in the Revenue and Taxation Code?
Well, it depends if you're referring to the California Constitution or the Revenue and Taxation Code sections.
No, I'm asking you for specific evidence, facts, proof that just because he's physically in California, your constitution applies to him, and you keep going back to the Revenue and Taxation Code. So either you're not understanding I'm asking you a question of fact, and you keep wanting to answer with an issue of law, or your position actually is, and it's astounding, that you're trying to convince me that that the evidence proving your constitution applies to him is your Revenue and Taxation Code. Which one is it?
Well, the information that you're referring to, that I'm looking for regarding the California Constitution, obviously is regarding the California Constitution. Now, specific proof that you're looking for, I don't have the information offhand. So, again, if you would like the specific facts or proof, then if you can submit that in writing, we can definitely have a chance to look into that and respond to that in writing.
Okay, but I will do that, but I'm telling you that a responsive answer to specific facts proving your constitution applies to him because he's physically in California is not going to be a legal citation. Yeah, I mean, you do understand the difference between an issue of fact and an issue of law.
Have you looked up the California Constitution to verify that there's not proof that it's regarding, would be sub, your client would be subject to, the, that there's proof that it's regarding California residents?
No, I'm going based on what my conversation I'm having with you right now. I'm asking you for the proof to support your claim. You're the one who put a claim through the United States mail, ostensibly in response to Mr. to Greg's request for evidence. You're the one making the claim. So I'm asking you what evidence you have to support your claim, and you can't give me anything. You've actually admitted several times that for specific facts, you can't give that to me at this time, that I'd have to give it to you in writing in order for you to respond.
Well, I mean, you can look up the Constitution, Article 4, Section 1, and also that would be a relevant section, and also Article 8, Section 26 of the California Constitution that covers, your inquiries.
Are you saying that the evidence that the Constitution applies to him is the Constitution itself?
I'm not quite following what you're asking.
You're telling me, because you're saying Article 4, Section 1 is evidence that the Constitution applies to him because he's physically in California. So what I'm asking you to do is clarify. Are you saying that the Constitution is evidence of itself that it applies to Greg just because he's physically in California?
Well, based on my research, he would be subject to the California Constitution and the Revenue and Taxation Code as being California resident, so
wait a
minute. He would fall within our jurisdiction to for personal income tax matters.
Wouldn't being a resident presuppose that the Constitution code already apply to him? Because being a resident means you've been in, it's a legal issue, correct?
I cannot comment on that.
Oh, so are you qualified to determine that he is subject to the law and a resident of California?
So based on our information, that would indicate that he is a California resident with California sourced income.
Okay, so you're qualified to say that, but you're not qualified to answer the other question.
Well, regarding the legality of the document, no, I cannot.
Well, are you qualified? Well, okay, because at this particular point, all right. Is it your position that the Constitution is evidence of itself or evidence that proving that it applies to Greg just because he's physically in California?
I'm not understanding your question, sir. What information you're trying to understand or receive.
Okay. Well, let's take isn't being a resident, isn't that a legal determination based on your code?
I cannot comment on that.
Okay, you can't comment on that, but you can make an affirmative statement that he is a resident based on your law. I can understand why you're getting so confused, because you're contradicting yourself over and over and over again.
Well, I'm just not completely understanding your statements or your questions or arguments. I don't understand fully what you're trying to divulge and understand.
Okay, you're saying that he's a resident, but doesn't that presuppose that your claim that the laws apply to him is already true? It's true. You're presuming the laws apply to him when you call him a resident, correct?
Correct.
Okay. So since that,
he would be subject to the California Revenue and Taxation Code being a California resident and based on income that has been earned and, okay. and taxed.
So that goes back to my original point. What specific facts, though, do you have to prove that just because he's physically in California that your constitution and code apply to him?
Well, the facts would be in the California Constitution itself regarding the article.
There you go. Let me write it down. In the Constitution itself. But where, all right, so are there any facts independent of the Constitution that would prove it applies to Greg just because he's physically in California?
Let's see here. Showing the Revenue and Taxation Code 17014 does define a resident.
Doesn't that presuppose that the code applies to him in the first place?
Yes.
So you're assuming it applies to him. So, again, that's not an answer to the question.
That defines the resident.
Defines the California resident. Yeah.
So did he meet that definition?
No. Does the Constitution apply to him in the first place, though? Doesn't logic dictate that the code has to apply to him in the first place to then be able to then reference what it says? What evidence is there the Constitution applies to him then?
I don't know how to answer specifically the specific evidence that you're looking for.
Let me write that down. You don't have the answer or specific. So at this time,
but again, if something that you want to submit that we can definitely research and respond to, be more than happy to.
Okay, but we've determined at this point already that you don't have any specific evidence to support your argument or your claim that the Constitution applies to him just because he's physically in California.
And I believe the proof that you're looking for would lie in both articles, but, you know, citing those right now, I don't have that information available.
You don't have the facts. Okay, you don't have... So you can't affirmatively state right now at this point that your constitution laws apply to him and that the Franchise Tax Board has any jurisdiction at all right now?
Are you indicating that they do not?
Based on your admissions that at this time you don't have the specific evidence, I wrote it down, you don't have the specific facts to support your claim. I'm just trying to get clarify what you're saying.
That he resides in California, he's domiciled in California.
Wait, we've already determined that you're assuming the laws apply to him. Before we go to the next step, we're just trying to clarify the situation right now. At this particular time, you don't have any specific facts or evidence to support your argument that the Constitution applies to Greg because he's physically in California and that the Franchise Tax Board has any jurisdiction over him.
Well, the evidence would be in his would be how the income is reported and is being a California address and resident.
Okay, but you're assuming that the Constitution code apply to him so that you can label him a resident, correct? We've already covered that. So now that you're throwing in the income, is it your position that the income proves your Constitution applies to him?
And I don't know if that's a specific link or not.
You don't know. Okay, so we're right back. Now, I know you may not want to admit this, but we've already got your admissions on the record now. I just want to be clear before we go to the next step. At this particular, just yes or no, at this point in time, during this phone call, in real time, you do not have any supporting facts or evidence to support your claim that the Constitution and Code apply to Greg and that the Franchise Tax Board has any jurisdiction over him at all?
Well, the evidence would be him being a California resident.
That's again, your opinion. We've already established it's your opinion, and you're assuming that your Constitution and laws apply. You even use the word assume. So making an assumption, you have to agree.
I didn't use the word assume.
Yeah, you did.
I didn't assume he's a resident. It's clear, based on his address, he's domiciled here.
You're assuming that your constitutional laws apply to him, though, and that's exactly what you said. I'm making a record of this phone call, too.
Are you recording this phone call?
Just like you are. Absolutely.
Okay, well, I'm going to have to ask you to stop recording. If not, I will have to terminate the call.
Why? You're recording on your end. And you're not going to
insurance purposes.
Are you going to give me a copy? You can say for whatever purposes you want. Are you going to give us a true copy of this recording?
Again, Mark, I will have to state if you do not stop recording the phone call, I will have to terminate the call.
Okay, you'll do. All right.